All right, welcome to the Friday chill stream, you guys. This is GTArajgaming, and as always, I am your host. I am the channel host, and I'm going to bring you some lovely, lovely retro goodness after I prematurely shift the microphone. Because for one, I need to type using the keyboard for a wee second, a hot sec. So let's see. I'll type with the keyboard tonight, it's a bit faster. Why have I put a space? That's terrible. And there we have it! The link is out. The link is most definitely out. So, tonight, we will be doing simulation mode, and Gran Turismo 2, nonetheless. It's a very, very favourite game of mine. Something very good from my childhood. But guys. I hope you guys do subscribe to the channel. Anyone new who's not subscribed already, why haven't you? The big red button is there to subscribe. And whilst you're at it, why don't you think of clicking that lovely little notification bell? It goes hand in hand with the subscribe button. They're literal besties, best mates. But if you wish to support the channel even further, there are things like super chats, memberships, and all sorts that you can do. Did we not click that properly? I didn't get a sound effect. Game, don't be doing this. Why is there like little to no sound on this? What? I can't even hear much. Like, ooh, that's not meant to happen. I can't even hear diddly squat from the game. One moment. Okay, I can hear a few pieces, but I may need to do a bit of an audio boost. How the hell am I going to do that? We can do, never mind. Right, let's see if wait, can we even do that? Like, is that a thing? I have never experienced this kind of thing before, so monitor. We really should be monitoring this, but never mind. Here's a thing. Ooh. You know what? I might have to fix the mic auxiliary thing here. That's what I normally ran the thing through. So, line in. Oh. Let's adjust this. Hopefully you all can hear things. If you cannot, I do apologize. So if someone's in the chat, if someone's in the chat, feel free to tell me if they can hear the game music. If they're unable to, then I'll have to make we'll just have to make do for now. But I do have the thing loaded, which is fantastic. Lovely jubbly. Ah, lovely jubbly. Hey, we'll find out the hard way after I'm done streaming. Because what I tend to do after I adjust the microphone, that may have sounded insanely weird, I do apologize. What I tend to do after I've done streaming is I tend to look back on the stream to see how audio quality is. Because things do change from when I first stream to when I do something else. Or from when I first stream, sorry. From when I first stream to like, from all the testing and all that. Never mind, I've screwed things up terribly. I do apologize. My point is, my point is, from when I do recording, I normally do sound testing, a whole bunch of the stuff. So things tend to change from when I do the test recordings to when I actually hit stream. Like, the microphone might be in a different position because I had to put the microphone away for whatever reason. But anyway, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. It does mean a lot when people subscribe and they enjoy my content. If people do enjoy Gran Turismo, I will be more than happy to stream it more often. I friggin' love this game so much. And I don't mean just the franchise, because, frankly, 2 is the high point of the franchise. It's just such a good play overall. Now, if you've missed the other live streams that I've done of this, then you'll know we've completed virtually all of the license tests. So that's definitely... Have we done them all yet? Did we finish... We finished all of the license tests, because to unlock the super license, you have to do B through International A. And we kind of did poorly in. Or rather, bronze isn't exactly poor, it's like average. If you have some silver, you're slightly above average, which is like, hey, above average. Fantastic. Now, on to a more important question, or something more important. How are you guys doing? Are you enjoying your Friday? Because Friday's a big thing for a lot of people. It's kind of a weekend. They're time away from work, so to speak. And I've just realized the filters aren't wrong. Oh my goodness. You're going to hear that. I know that for a fact. Or should I? Never mind. Okay, that's distracting, so I'll just leave it as is. I do apologize. I very much do apologize. I know things should be set up in advance of the stream, but that's kind of not how I do things. I do things a little differently. Some things are left to the last minute for one reason or another. Anyway, let's get into the good stuff. I need to see how what my car is like, because it's literally been a hot minute since I've touched this game in particular. So we're at 291 PS. That's basically the equivalent of horsepower. I think that's the max the car will go. So let's pick an event and do a little bit of grinding. Because some of the harder events, you have to do the license tests. Now, quick tip. This is a bloody quick tip. If you want Or, not if you want. If you're able to, you can earn free vehicles from the license test. If you complete each stage in gold, this is passed over from GT1, so that's why that's like that. If you pass over a save from GT1, license test wise, you do not unlock the car. So keep that in mind. If you convert your GT1 save to 2, you do not get the vehicle. So, right. If you complete each stage of the license test in gold, for example, if you finish the entire B license with a gold, you will be given a vehicle free of charge. Now, in the Japanese version, you start off with 1,000,000 credits. That's the equivalent to 10,000 credits in the English release of the game. Which means there's a fair bit of wiggle room for you to upgrade the car right off the bat and have something overpowered for competing in the Sunday Cup. Now, I've forgotten which license gives you which car. One of them is the Dodge Concept car. So, if you want to go and absolutely destroy the Clubman Cup or the Sunday Cup, you could, in fact, take the... Well, I'd recommend the Sunday Cup, because there's no limit on them. You just take in an overpowered car and just absolutely destroy the opposition. The point is, if you get gold in each of the license tests, all of them, for each letter that you complete in gold, free car. Why wouldn't you try for that? I mean, I'm not, because that would literally take all stream, and I'll be honest, I'll be brutally honest, that would be boring. Not only for the viewer, but for myself. And we need to find a balance of where the audience enjoys themselves and where I also enjoy myself. There needs to be a balance. Anyway, before I end up breaking ritual, so to speak, tonight's drink of choice is Iron Brew Energy. Sugar-free. It's Iron Brew's take on friggin' energy drink. They've done it before with Iron Brew 32 a long, long time ago, and the advertisements for that were insane. Now, it's not a brand sponsor anymore. I mention what I'm drinking based on what I have at the time. If I were to do a sponsorship, or if I got a sponsor and brands wanted shoutouts and stuff, then I would very much alert the audience to the sponsorship. That would be posted in the community tab, so if you haven't got notifications turned on, you really wouldn't know about it. Unless you stop the community tab. Oh my goodness. Right, oh my goodness. We need to find a race to do. Midship challenge. That's 350 PS. I don't think we're a mid-engine car. Or, mid-engine rear drive. Sorry about that. Yeah, we don't need that requirement. Right, so we now have to go and pick another vehicle to do a race in. But what I would also alert you guys to is the fact that if you've never played Gran Turismo 2 before, there's numerous events, and it runs throughout the entire franchise from 2 onwards. There's certain events where you can earn vehicles just by competing, just by coming in first. Now, from my recollection, these change later on. Like, multiple events will have multiple cars that you can win. And to get the car that you want, you have to do the event in order. Now, I don't know if it's like that in the Japanese version. Because there's different changes made for each region. That's FR, we don't want that. Do we have to rely on this 1.4 litre vehicle? Oh, thank God, don't. So we haven't. The two slates are FR, I think. Let's check out what our Let's check out what our silver key is. That's also FR. So we, if we wanted to, and I believe I will, let's grind. Grinding can be fun depending. So we've got an FR car. Clubman stage, or special stage, or clubman stage. I believe it's clubman stage. Clubman stage, route 5 will give you that slating, I do believe. That's just my take on it. Might not. If it doesn't, it's no big deal. It literally isn't a big deal. So we do have modifications on the vehicle. We don't have suspension yet. Too poor for that. So we do have a full customization gear kit. Computer in the engine, stage 2 turbo. All the good stuff that you need to make your car go from 0 to 60. Much quicker. It gets better when you introduce custom tuning setups, where you can go from 0 to 60 in a 0.5 of a second. I may have to change my de-interlacer for this. Let's just see how we handle first and foremost. I do believe moving images with the blend de-interlace does not... It's not really working properly. Or, it doesn't look nice when things are moving. Yeah, no, that's a... When it's moving, that's a bloody mess, so... One moment, please. The interlace. What do we have on before Yadif? Oh, that's crispy. That's very crispy. So the benefit of joining my streams is that if things mess up, you get to see me fix them in real time. Hopefully. Linear just makes the image bounce, but let's try it when we're moving. Oh, that is quite nice when we're moving. That's quite, things do seem a bit weird first. Jesus Christ. Oh my god, we're unstable. This is an unstable build of the Silver King. Now, if you caught the first stream I did, I recommended this card highly because it was valid. One of them was sitting at, 200,000 credit. No, yeah, 200,000 credits at the start of the game. Keep in mind, in the Japanese version, you had 1 million credits. So think of the upgrade possibilities. If you're unable to do the licenses, or rather, if you haven't done them all in gold, then this is your go-to card. Because for its price, it's still powerful. So you can at least compete fairly fine. Within, like, the Clubman Cup. Sunday Cup. Good God! I keep getting these things mixed up. I've been playing this game since I was a wee lad. I should know these things. I even had to print out... Years ago, I had to print out lists of vehicles that you can earn. From friggin' Gran Turismo 2. And the events they dropped in. I don't have that list anymore, sadly. Which is, I missed the list. It's one of the few things I've printed out from my home printer. Also, print. Because I haven't said printer or print enough. You'll notice this is a very, very short race, and I've just crashed. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. Oh no. Oh, hi guys at the back, how you doing? Thanks for coming out to race me. But I'm sorry, I've won. So there we go. 1:07.33. And there's another silver case right behind me. The S13. So we've now won. So it's either that slaty or the 1.4 litre vehicle behind us. So we get 500,000 and a vehicle. The downside here is there's no pole position thing. So in Gran Turismo 1, all of the races were kind of bundled into a section. So you'd have the FR challenge. Once you click on it, you'd automatically challenge all three races. Before each race, you would have a chance to try for pole position, which is positions 1 through 3. And if you came in pole position, or if you came in first during the... what's the trial? Something like that. If you came in first in trial, then you'd gain a significant bonus there and then, and then you'd go on to do the actual race. Okay, so this, to confirm, the Slaty, or Slighty, or Silaty, that's what would be the name. The Slaty is the one that drops from the event that we just done, from that one race. So that's fantastic, that's great. If you want some quick tips, the bit where the arrow is, that means change. The second one means sell. So we could sell this if we wanted to, like right here. We get 200,000 for it. Done. We get, I think it's retail value for it. Maybe not. I have no idea. I don't even know the brand that does it. So, there may be a hint, may not be. So this is the car's basic information like weight, horsepower, rev, that kind of thing. That's kind of the boring stuff. Even in the English that's Nissan, nice. So even in the English version, you still have a nice bio. Oh, and before we go on, I do need to stress this. Some cars, some vehicles in this do have different names from their retail release. Like the Nissan Primera, that's got a different name entirely in the Japanese release. So do keep that in mind. Also, we're borderline rich again. So we don't necessarily need this 1.4 liter Volkswagen Lupo. However, that's a nice sum of cash for it. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to change into the Nissan Silaty, and we are going to upgrade this and see what we can do. And I've just realized I've clicked the home button again. Oh my goodness. It's been too long since I've played this. I've missed it. What some people might find weird is that a lot of the things in the game are in English. So, yeah, that's a thing. Isn't that what we're just... That's a Primera. Ain't she Primera wagon? Let's see if we can find our vehicle. Maybe on page one. It's a basic thing. Which is fine. Yeah, it's not on page one. We don't have the weird kanji. So that's a silver S15. 15 again, that's 1999. This game is... I think this game is 1998, 1999. At that time. I don't even know. But we have the Skyline, Stage A. The Nissan Sunny for whoever it is. Okay, let's go back. We're going to go to the used market. And not purchase that vehicle, that silver cues. But look at that, it's 276,000 for the Q's S13. Now the one I picked up was about 140-150 horsepower. Which for 200,000 credits, that's a fantastic deal. Don't get me wrong. It's a brilliant deal. So we can find our vehicle, that would be nice. if it's not in the used lot, we'll have to come back later on. It doesn't appear to be here. Because we're mostly getting the silver K's and skylines. Why? Why is there so many skylines in the used catalog? Even for 1999, that's still a stretch. Because I do believe that was a popular vehicle, even IRL. Either way, we are tuning this bad boy. Let's see what we could push out of it. Okay. Wait, what? So what? One thing you might notice, it's kind of niche. But some vehicles' horsepower is actually less than what the in-game doodah displays. Like, let's see our Celati for one. Yeah, that's a 204 PS, but I think it was advertised trying to say it's a little bit less than that. When it came to things like, wait, can we do oil change? No, we can't. Oil change is a Gran Turismo 3 thing. One wash, 5,000 credits. What the hell? That's only 50 credits in later games. Whoever charges 5,000 credits for that is clearly high. They're clearly high on the bad stuff. But anyway, back to tuning. Oh my goodness. Let's see what kind of power we can get out of the Celati. Oh wow. It goes all the way up to stage 3. But I do think we should be buying this. Yes. We're now at 280 PS. Which already might end up being a little bit better than the silver. Can we buy a new muffler? 500,000. Jesus, man. Terrible. Right. But just because of that, we're going to switch back to the silver. You see, the downside here is I don't have a customizable transmission. And they're very expensive. Well, might not have had that hand. Yeah, customizable transmissions are fairly expensive. So we're going to have to grind a few events. Let's see what we can do. I have done a bit more than what I've let on here. That's another race that we have done. Oh, it's not here. There was a race that we'd done before and I got slapped in it. Oh, it's Global Compact. Yeah, we should do that a few times. Alright. That's requires the B license. We already have the B license. It's perfectly fine. So a lot of races tend to have limits, and I'm not a big fan. Oh, well, I don't. You should be able to upgrade your car on the fly, even if you have components to make the car slower. It should still let you compete and let you switch them out. Oh. Alright, so after having that brief drink unannounced, I should say, let's get into this race, which we're losing. And I have lost this race a number of times, but that was due to different reasons. At one point I ended up failing it because I spun out and they all passed. And by the time I tried to get ahead, it was like, hey, I'm way too far ahead. Look at this! This is some weird thing right here. Because the cars don't actually take damage, they're not being careful, they're just ramming you wherever. So it was like, hey, I need to pay attention! Terrible! Oh my goodness, you guys. come on! I'm getting beat by Toyota hatchbacks, not that. Or compacts. Basically hatchbacks. So this is Autumn Ring's full course. It doesn't matter which one you do, it's still a terrible course. Oh my goodness, terrible. There's a terrible course. Brum brum! So I do have to cut corners in certain cases. But at least I can commentate and drive better than Chris Evans ever did in Top Gear. Because if you read the early reports about him like doing Top Gear, he couldn't drive and talk properly. He was always distracted. Like me right now. I'm only distracted because I'm trying to look at the chat to see if there's any messages in case someone decides to drop a message and then just like disappear. Because I absolutely hate it when that happens. I've had that a few times. Where somebody pops in and is like, hey, what's up? Or something. And by the time it pops up for me, they've disappeared. It's the downside of having the delay on YouTube for like chat. Brum brum! Come on! We need to get in first to get this card. Oh my day! Oh, crap, crap, crap. Oh my god. Yeah, they're too far ahead of me now to catch up properly. If anything, I'm getting pennies reward money. Concentrate. It doesn't help that my... Oh my god! Oh man. Yeah, this is turning out to be quite the dumpster fire. And I'm braking at the right time as well, and the car just wants to veer. It's like, hey... It's kind of disheartening. Like, it's trying to do it there, but I was able to catch it. But now I've lost the race because we spun out twice. Yeah. Minute 45. It's garbage. I was 8 seconds behind! We were beaten by a Peugeot 106. Toyota Vip. Mazda Demio, one of the slowest vehicles in the game, a 16V Renault Clio, an Opel. Oh my goodness. How embarrassing! It's a terrible thing. I should have been at least 5 seconds faster than my first time. But we don't get any vehicle. We do not get any vehicle. It's like the biggest oof of the race. Or of the game. As if you come in last. And it's like totally not your fault. I noted when I was building... I noted when I first built the car that it was a bit tricky to drive. In Gran Turismo. So if we try something a little bit slower with potentially worse acceleration, then we should be good to go. Hopefully. But either way, I do hope people who enjoy Gran Turismo also enjoy this, even though I am very much screwing up. Once you get your B license, this is the race you should be grinding. And it's easy to see why. It's very, very easy to see why. And I can tell you. Because the Volkswagen Lupo that we got was 400,000 credits in value. Now that's good. It means you'll be able to get more cash to friggin' spend on vehicles. One moment, please, because good god, this headset. To make sure I'm not being too loud, I had one ear uncovered. And the headset just decides to like slip off. I'm like, god, no. Oh, and to mention the chat thing from earlier. Yeah. People might say, oh, put your YouTube chat on the screen. But that's not very effective. Because if you do that, then there's a big notification on the chat itself. It's like, hey, don't forget to follow the community guidelines. And frankly, the notification looks ugly. Like, beside a video game. It's absolutely terrible. It's the reason why I took the YouTube chat off the screen. That, and I kept failing to get a custom YouTube chat. So that's the thing. I'm going to work on that, because I do want the chat to show up on screen, because in OBS it makes it easier for me to see, and it means I don't have to use my mobile phone, to friggin' stay on all the time to look at the chat. Because if somebody's chat comes through, I very much want to answer it. I want to get conversation. Because for one, it's a chill stream. Come in and chat. It's fine. You can ask me things. Although, I may have to go back on that one a little bit until I hit 1500 subs. Because I'm doing a Q&A when we hit 1500 subs. Excuse you? Excuse you, sir. Could you, like, get behind me? Okay, thanks. Yeah, this is handling reasonably well, I may add. Like, I don't feel anything slipping, even though we've increased the power on the vehicle, like, a ton. Alright, Renault or Peugeot, get your ass back here. What? One of the things that we need to work on is vehicle acceleration. That's the thing that will get you knocked to 60 really quick. It'll increase your launch times and the chances of you slipping out. Terrible. Oh my goodness! Twice in a row! We are not getting first place again. We may not even get fifth. This one was all me. Like, I wasn't looking at the chat, so I couldn't blame that as a distraction. There's no way I could do that. That was my own stupidity and volition. Which is ironic, considering I ripped on Chris Evans. And I'm like, yo. I'm crashing. I'm sliding. I'm doing donuts in the grass. We might get fifth if we don't decide to slide out. And keep in mind, these cars are also below 300 PS. Come on, come on, come on, come on! Oh my goodness, no. Let's see who we're up against. A Volkswagen Lupo, Opel Corsa, Nissan March, G. Still 80. Nice. Fantastic. So you might notice a pattern here. The AI has gotten faster. It's gotten faster. Maybe not faster. Maybe so. I don't know. The game will not show us our previous time from the last run. Which is disappointing, honestly. It really is disappointing. Because I would like to compare it with the last run. And I know the game is able to do that because you have rankings. But either way, we have to be careful and not slide out on this. If we don't slide out, then we win. If we slide out from either... If we slide out from either our own stupidity, or if the AI just wants to yeet the living daylights out of us, then we have to... We'll end up losing. And it's not something I'm comfortable with. Now, I'm not gonna become a DSP, Dark Side Phil, and be like, "Ugh, it's the controller, ugh, somebody's using underhanded tactics." As a matter of fact, they kind of were. They were trying to pit maneuver us out the race. And that's why we slid out once. Which caused us to slide out a second time when trying to stabilize. The other times, it was just my stupidity. That's a thing. Darkseid Phil, he's... Yeah, he's one guy just very much want to piss off. Just by fighting him in a fighting game. If he loses, he will try and claim that using underhanded tactics. Or maneuvers that are BS, that he doesn't like. It's just stupid. Now you get your backside back here so I can... Oh, I've overtaken. Nice. Careful. Now, when you're sliding cars, the AI can and will try and pit maneuver. It'll hit one side of your car, and if you're trying to slide around a corner, you are out of there. You're on the grass, and it's going to take you a while to get back on the road. So keep that in mind. Let's see. I notice I'm not as slippery as I would be before. But I am paying close attention to what I'm doing. And around the second last corner of the race. Of the lap. And he crosses the finish line into the second lap of the race. Alright. Yeah, I'm not a very commentator passenger in these races. It's like... I need to focus. If I need to focus, I am going to be a significant part... A significant section quieter. Quieter. If words would form properly. Of course. Brum brum! We can look back. Excuse you! Oh my goodness. This is the second time that's happened. This time it was me trying to slip around the corner. And I did slip out, wasn't there? Because I don't have my headphones on, I can't hear. So for all I know, it could have been them clanking into me. No! You absolute dirty anal bead! Yeah, this is kind of infuriating now. There's no true words that could explain this situation. Like, the car seems to handle just fine now. Like, that corner, I'm doing the same things that they're now, braking, letting off the acceleration, and then pushing on the acceleration when I go around the corner. Oh my goodness. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. 8 seconds behind again! Jeepus, man! This is terrible. I know I'm not the best at this, but come on. Oh my goodness. Remember, guys, if you haven't subscribed to the channel already, make sure you have, and make sure to click that notification bell to be notified whenever I stream, whenever I upload, whenever I post in the community tab. And if you'd like to see me fail at Gran Turismo, drop a like. Because Jesus... I don't mean drop a like for Jesus. You can drop a like for Jesus if you want, but that's up to you. I do need to prioritise grip, which means my car has to stick to the ground more, so I don't slide out. Downside is, I have very, very much picked a Japanese car, which most of them are drifters. Yeah, a lot of vehicles in Gran Turismo come from Japan, and a lot of them are tuned to be out of the box. A lot of them are tuned to be like drift missiles. Sort of. It's not the right analogy, but you get the idea. You get the idea. So we do have to be careful. I know some of the cars in the audience, well, not the audience, but the lineup. I noticed that I can improve on my acceleration. I just need transmission. So brake here, and then slowly go around the corner. Oh, there's a Clio in the lineup. Oh no. There's a lot of understeer going on, put it that way. And it's not as if the car can't keep up. The car certainly can. Oh, it really can. The car itself is faster than what's there. It's the fastest car in this entire lineup, but its handling varies wildly. Like right now, look at that. That is some great handling. But when you try to slide it, the car gets out of control. And that is not something that I like. I don't like it. So we have to fix it, and to fix it we need grip tires, we need a brake controller and all that, which will mostly fix it. Oh, come on, Peugeot, get out of my way. Ow. Terrible! Yeah, they're pulling ahead, they've clearly got an acceleration overhead on us. But like we saw before, I was pulling ahead quite thick. Their brakes aren't Their stopping power is not as good as ours. Excuse you. Yeah, we're starting to slip. As soon as the car gets to higher speeds, it slips. Good God, Reynolds! You just look at that. Just try to push him out. The AI on this is wonky, but also leads to challenges. It makes things more challenging, but at the same time, what they do can be mistook for underhanded tactics. I'm not saying that's what they're using, because all the vehicles are following a predetermined race line. If they step out of their race line, then they're stepping out of boundaries and they'll try to get back into it. So if I'm in the opposition's race line, they're going to try and get back into it. Even if they're right next to me or behind me or whatever. Doesn't really matter. And I'm itching. Terrible. Terrible! It's not something that you want to happen when you're trying to do a high pressure race. Brake here. If we do it right, we have this in the back. And across the leg! So if you notice, this lineup is significantly faster than what originally came out. Because if you remember, a bunch of vehicles were at least 8 seconds behind. Now none of them are. Some of the cars that were there included the Volkswagen Lupo, the Renault Clio, and the Peugeot 106. One of our total time at one point was, I believe, 3 minutes 35. So things vary. And as you saw, it can vary quite drastically. Lap 1, when we first did it, 1 minute 45 with the silver. We got something closer to that when we used the Silly 2. And I didn't drive that differently than what I do now. Things are varying. You are seeing this firsthand. Well, is streaming counted as firsthand? Because I'm seeing it first. And then you're seeing it by a 10 to 20 second delay. Does that count? Does that count as you seeing it firsthand? I don't think so. So because we get the Lupo for this, which is obviously a massively upgraded car to compete in a 300 horsepower race. So look at that. And the 1.4 is a 75 horsepower vehicle. Yet it was in that race and it came second last. Now, if the one in the race was 75 horsepower, that thing would have been left in the dust a long, long time ago. Which, it really should be. But it's a car that gives you a bunch of money, so meh. Yeah, I'm no bother. So what we'll do it once more. That'll net us a profit of about 900,000 credits, which would put us back up to 1,800,000 credits, I believe. If my math is right, most of the time my math is wrong, but that's just me, never mind. So, right now, grab yourself a drink. Try not spit it out, because that's distracting for you. And before I mention, the second drink of choice is once again Volvic summer fruits, sugar-free. It's actually got a nice taste to it. The taste on it's quite... It tastes like water, but it's also like a mix of fruits. So it's kind of nice. It's not like I don't get an artificial taste from it, which is, it's more than what could be said for a lot of other drinks that are sugar free. So that's the thing. If you ever wanted a sugar free drink, Volvic Summer Fruits is ya boy. Now, I don't know if I ever explained why tonight... I don't know if I ever explained why tonight's stream is late. Or at a vastly later time than normal. I normally stream between 6 p.m. GMT and 7 p.m. GMT. But tonight's 8. There's a few reasons which I'll get into now. One of them... One of the reasons I done it late is because at the usual time, the sun was out. Now that's all fine and dandy. But because of the position of the desk, the monitor, and the overall heat in my room at the time, it was kind of a no-brainer to be like, hey, I'm going to have the stream later. I hope you're able to join. Another part to it was heat. It's been a very hot day in Scotland, for once. And I'm like, yeah, it's peak heat times. It's like 20 degrees outside, or was. And, yeah, that's not the best. It's not the best to do a stream when you're partially dehydrated and at 20 degrees heat. It's a thing. I didn't like the heat. Plus, the sun was shining in and actually obscuring my vision from seeing what was on the monitor properly. And closing the blinds at the time would have kind of increased the heat a fair bit. Because it's not letting air in or out. The air would just become warm, I'd get hotter, and poof! That would have meant I would have had to end the stream early, and I don't like doing that. So let's try and get around this corner. But yeah, that's why I was late tonight. It's a lot cooler than it was earlier. Granted, it's still warm. Not as warm. Excuse you, Pujo. Thank you. You're in your rightful position. Third place. Yeah, we missed the timing to clip him. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. So we're about to go and remedy that. Because I think... that car might just improperly handle... on a corner. Or brake at a different time from my car. And then we just overtake. And he overtakes again, but that's because of the cars being at different speeds. They all have to brake at different times, which if you're a skilled driver, you can take advantage of that and just like overtake them on a corner. Who just did that? Oh my. Hashtag how not to play Gran Turismo. I don't even know why I spun out. I'll have to listen back. Because if it's another car that done it, then I'm going to be so pissed. If only we had the ability to take car damage, then the AI would be doing any of this. We wouldn't get something like that until Forza came out. And that wasn't for another, 3, 4, 5 years. Yeah, we're in dead last. We're, for some reason, we're not catching up, even though we clearly have better acceleration. Since in the start of the race, we were able to clearly overtake you guys. My ears are just being terrible. Come on! So that's why I wasn't turning! That idiot was trying to turn against me! He was pushing me to the side. Ah! Bugs. Don't spin out! We have a chance! Oh my god, you absolute anus! Oh my tits McGee! 9 times out of 10, you're gonna get screwed over. I just did! Oh, this is balls like. It's not like the car can't compete! It can! It's a very competitive car! It's just that someone spun us out. I do not appreciate that. That was so bad. Like, in all honesty, that was one of the worst races. The first spin out, I don't know if that was me, or if it was another vehicle. Like I said, the vehicles have done it before. Then we come to the guy, right next to us, outside of our field of vision, or field of view or whatever, who was trying to turn when I was trying to turn. Thus slowing me down and preventing me from turning into the getting into the apex even further. That's a thing. It's just how the AI is programmed. You cannot spin them out. However, they can spin you out. And I feel that's a bit garbage. So what do you say? We go and get some tires if we're able to. Cause getting tires in this, oh boy. Oh boy! It's a chore. Because it costs a whole ton to get them. Sports tires. We don't want sports tires. It's not what we're after. I've forgotten which is better for racing, soft or hard. Because the way I think of it is, when the tires are hot and hard, they grip more. Whereas if they're soft and cold, or soft and hot I should say, they tend to slip and then you'll go into a drift. We want to avoid that. However, we do need to increase our brake power. So we need an approximate 1,600,000 credits. Now, we could potentially get some of that now. But that would leave us with 1,300,000 credits. And we get it by selling the Lupo. I don't know what I'm going to do here. Ugh, terrible. It's terrible when I have to think about things and I shouldn't have to think about things at certain points. Why is my chair so squeaky, is it? Never mind. Hopefully the microphone's not even picking up the squeaks. I don't care, but... Yeah, We don't get vehicles. We don't get cars for this. You only get cars for doing the other events. And you don't get cars for the first few events. But you do start with the challenges. So we want to try and, you know, do the challenges. Lightweight cake. In order for us to do that, we'd have to upgrade the lipo and then slap a few mods on it. 100 PS for a B class and an A and for an A class as well. That's kind of top tier. So I think we're going to do that. We'll do the free one at 150 PS. So we need to find Volkswagen. The dealership. And then put on some turbo, I guess. If the event itself is easy enough, then oh boy. Ooh. We are in the wrong part of town. This is France and Italy. Bonjour! So North City, I think... Oh yes. Volkswagen, Lister, Opel, Lotus, Jaguar, Mini and MG, Rough, BMW, Mercedes-Benz, Aston Martin. And here's the big boss man of all. TVR. Oh boy, they have some very good cars. Oh. Let's see. Yeah, the Griffith Blackpool B340. They have this TVR Speed 12, which is here, I think. Or is this just a racing lineup? Oh no, 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 that's the Speed 12. Which one is this? The Toucan or Tuscan? Toucan Speed 6. That's actually a good car, but you cannot buy it. When cars have the buy thing grayed out, that means it's a competition car. You have to beat an event to get it. Oh my god, the Jordi! Why? Garbage! Ah, terrible. Alright. Volkswagen, let's get this friggin' lupo up. Let's get the lupo up. So it's currently at 75 PS. Let's put that up to 81. A muffler will do the trick. In some cases, it doesn't matter if the vehicle is underpowered. Ooh, Oh my, again with the Yoni! I am very sorry for that. Let's see. Yeah, that won't do as good. So long as we can get to the 100 mark, or close to it. Really, the port polish puts the PS up by 1. Garbage! Can it be naturally aspirated though? No. There's like one car in the game that can be both naturally aspirated and have turbo slapped on it. Good god, me in cheer. Terrible. So our only option is to go for turbo. Or just do various bits here. Yeah, let's put us up by 3 PS. Terrible. That's a million for like 3 PS. Arrgh, let's reset. Garbage! Going in all data, eh? Yeah, we don't have enough for that. We don't have enough for the measly 1 PS. So, right, we're going to do the lightweight cake up. We can do the free one. We'll be 60 PS behind if we do the free one. However, I'm not going to let that stop me. Not by any means. If you've made it this far in the stream, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Make sure you click that notification bell to be notified whenever I stream, upload, or do anything in the community tab. How much of a difference is there going to be? If you want to see me continually play this and or fail, then feel free to drop. If you want to support the channel, you can either send a donation to the link in the description. It's either Streamlabs or Stream Elements. You can send a super chat if you wish. Or, beg for, or you can become a channel member. Being a channel member grants you exclusive benefits. And I do hope that people enjoy the benefits that I'm offering. Ooh, sir, you're not getting it. Okay. Yeah, membership benefits do vary. I'm working on the big tier. Personally, I want to make sure it's worth it for the people that want to go that far to support. So that's a definite. So the price and the benefit for the World Trader tier is subject to change at any time. The Scout and Knight tier, they will, for the foreseeable future, will not be changing. If I decide to make a change, I will put the word out there before I make the change. So people who are members already, before the change, will be notified. It'll be put as a members only post first, and then a public post. So that's the thing. Yeah, he's taking a second from me. Excuse you, sir. You know what? I'm not even worried at this point. Because we are about to overtake, and I am very much happy to do so. Like that. Head around the corner we go. Because the car is slow enough that you can just drive around the corner to varying degrees. And as long as we get in their way, they can't be fast. And he's across the line! Brilliant. So that's a Daihatsu. And then there's a Mazda AZ1. Subaru Vivio. Suzuki Servo. Suzuki Alfa. Okay. Not that I would drive them, mind you. There'd be no need for that. So, we got almost 10 seconds faster than or rather 11 seconds faster than not even that. Never mind! My mind's poo-poo. my mind is poo poo. I still say it's about 11 seconds, so it was faster. Which is very noticeable. So we're going to do a quick trap. Let's do the boarding thing first. Let's see what we got, and let's see what its resale value is. If the resale value is high, that boy's getting sold. Oh, he's not getting sold. Yet. A Mugen Beat. Good God. You're getting sold, pal. Frankly, that was an easy race. There was no dickage. They weren't trying to spin me out. Well, they might have. They may have tried. Would have failed. So here's the thing. Even though the PS cap is lower, the AI might be better. So there's a chance that you are going to get shanked. Or there's a chance that I'm going to get shanked. We'll just have to wait and see. We're only 20 odd PS behind. Ow. Never mind. I'm just a bit sore. I may have bitten my gum earlier, not realized. Terrible. So like I said, the PS cap might be lower, but the skill of the driver AI might be higher. The same goes with the car's power overall. It might be higher. Because here's how I figure, right? Here's how I think. Once the chair stops squeaking, that is. So, the PS cap for the first race was 150. And we're at, what, 84? That's a 60 PS difference. My driving wasn't too different from theirs. So, if the PS of the cars that were in that race were 150, then that's terrible. There's no way that cars at 150 PS perform like that. They would have been ahead by at least 2 seconds. By all accounts, because of how underpowered my car was. It just goes to show that you don't have to be exactly on the minimum, on the max requirement to do the race. All you have to do is have a drivable car. I mean, obviously there's other variables like how fast you or they get from 0 to 60. That's a given. Wait, this is the short course, isn't it? Yeah, short course. 3, 2, 1, break. It just means they will have to brake later than I do for going around corners after I crash. Crashed again. Nice. Lovely. I'm setting a great example for Gran Turismo players worldwide. I'm setting a great example for all the players worldwide. Terrible. Oh, come on, sir. Here's the thing, we still have plenty of time to reclaim first place. So that's the thing. Some of their gear shifts might be different from mine. Some of their gear shifts might be better. If indeed they are better, then there's a less likelihood that I'll win. We have to take that chance. Whether or not we like it. 3, 2, 1, break! We would have had that if we didn't try fast. But it's clear But some of these vehicles have better acceleration. Which is why they just rock your head. Turn. That's one of the mistakes I made last time. Right, this Fiat Coupe is doing my head. Come here, you! You're on the list! Yeah, we are not taking first. Excuse you? We're taking third, which means no vehicle for us. Now, I recognize that I made a plug, big plug. Suzuki Alto Works, what? That's a downgraded version of the one that was in the last race. And yet it's winning! We were like several seconds ahead of it in the last race, in the free race. Which proves my point about AI. The AI driving that car is a wee bit better than the AI that was in the free race. Keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. Look at that, we got third. If I keep this drinking up, I'm gonna be out of juice or water. I do believe that I should not have stopped or put brakes on during that first lap. At that one point where I slowed down. If I didn't do that, I would have been able to hold first place for a bit longer. Who knows? I might have been able to win the race. I'll never know. Unless it happens again. So one of the things we have to we need to get the acceleration sorted. Look at this. They're all slow as ass, mate. Look at the lead we are beginning to pull on them. It goes to show that in certain cases they do have better acceleration. They are a ways behind. A second, I think. Maybe not even. So the corner that's coming up here, we do not brake. Absolutely not. Because that is what got us screwed over the first time. Brake right here. Yeah, since we're in the lead, we're getting better corners because there's no AI drivers trying to get past us. Well, now there is because I screwed it up. But you get the general idea. Yes. Break. Almost a perfect light. Break. And the coupe is trying to overtake. Sir, stop that! We forced them to slow down a bit. Which is good. Very, very good. So what we need to do is make sure we can brake in 3, 2, 1. Force the car out of its line. And hopefully something else comes along. Yeah, we've lost that one. But who knows, we might be game first. So that's there. I've just got distracted. Terrible. It's a kind of bad habit, I'll admit. We are so close. But still so far away. And we're back into first and then second. Lovely. Lovely jubbly, isn't it? So we don't have much time to get back into first. So we need to rig something up. That could have been the jump we needed. We do in fact need to time when we have to brake and when we don't have to. Great, now we're in fourth, because of this bloody coupe thing. Now for some reason, their acceleration's starting to get overpowering. It's drastically different. It's drastically different from the start of the race, when they were going like ass. Mazda AZ1? Terrible. So if you saw the beginning of the race, their acceleration was ass. It was terrible. They put on a brake, their brakes to go around the corner, and now all of their accelerations decided to start ramping up. I don't know why they shouldn't be doing that. If they're going around a corner and they slow down, the acceleration should still be the same. So we're doing it again. Now keep in mind, we cannot get too close to 100 PS, or else we cannot do the race. That's just a simple fact of the matter. We are at something like 85 PS, which in this game is horsepower. It's their version of horsepower before it'll translate. Watch carefully. Watch carefully. Their acceleration is ass. Look how fast I have caught up. In theory, they would be on the same gear as I am. Especially going round that corner in the last race. I would have been able to catch up, no problem. But something happened. Now their acceleration is better. They're on gear 3. Now I am. At random points in the race, the cars become better than they were before. I don't know why. It shouldn't have happened. Let's see. I may have silent pauses, or rather just pauses, but that's just me trying to keep concentrated. Check that. That's a great turn. We don't even need to brake one around that corner. That's good. That's very good. The more we learn about what we need to do and what we don't need to do, it's getting better and better by the time. Better and better by the minute, I should say. Although this guy in front of us is a bit of a pain, so. Brake. And we have a better chance of going around corners than they do if we break out. This means we can get around to higher speeds on corners. Why is he so much faster if we were way faster at the beginning of the race? Very curious. Catch up even turned off. Because if you turn off catch-up, it makes it notoriously hard to get in first again if you lose your position. Yeah, we just clipped the side of the barrier, we're not getting out of this. For some reason, the guy's too overpowering. It's like, hey, I'm in first, you're not taking back. So let's... It's going to be a head-to-head. Can we do it? Can we even do it? Can we keep second? I don't think we can. This Demi was catching up. Sir? No, 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 no. Thank you. Yeah, he was sick. The auto works! That's depressing! It's depressing. Because for those of you who saw the first race, will know that I absolutely clapped their cheeks. Sure, they kept up, but they didn't get ahead. It's AI. The AI is driving significantly better. The next best thing would be to stay behind the lead car and try to force them to go faster around a corner. Which you can do is when he slows down, you keep accelerating. And he doesn't slow down as fast and then the AI makes a mistake. You can do that. I do not recommend it. I seriously don't. Where are we going? North? Let's get this boy some up. Shall we? Not too many. We mainly need brakes. Get your brakes on! Get your brakes on! Yes, we want these. Give it to me now! Give me them! And in return, I shall give you something better! Hurrah! Okay, so now we have our brakes. It means we can brake way better than we did before. Rather than using factory stock brake discs. Knowing is half the battle. Sure, it's a G.I. Joe reference, but it still applies. It literally still applies regardless of what you think. So we've been learning. We know which parts of the course we don't need to brake on, which results in a somewhat advantage. So, what's the orientation of the car? Is it like MR or something? If it's an FR, then we want the rear brakes to be tighter, a bit more loosey-goosey. So we'll try with a 10 on the front pads, discs, if I can even talk properly, and then we'll go with a 16 on the back. Now this is just changing the tightness, or how tight the brakes, well, do their job. The tighter they are, the harder you'll brake, and there's a bigger opportunity to oversteer or understeer. And the same can be said about loosening them up. You won't brake as much, but you'll still have the ability to swim? The hell am I thinking? It's not swim. You'll still have the ability to like drift, or slide, or whatever, what have you. So keep that in mind when you're trying to tighten and loosen your brake discs. We'll have better control. Well, we've already got brake force. Let's see how different we perform. If we understeer or oversteer more, then we have a problem. If we do not, if we understeer and oversteer less, and we brake better, then we're doing a good job. Look at the difference between me and them at the start of the race. That's at least 1.5 seconds, maybe more. So let's brake. I'm noticing differences. The tire compound is not doing a good job, so that's what's next for this vehicle. We're not selling this, we need this now. So it just means we need to pick, I think, hard tires. Hard racing tires. Sports won't cut it, so we need to raise another 1 point something million in order to do what we need to do. Yeah, we clipped the barrier twice. But look at that, we're still doing a good job. We are racing quite thin. I had to apply the brakes a bit there, I was a bit too quick. So, once here. We don't need to apply the brakes going around this corner. We're able to keep the car stable even more now. To varying degrees, because we still have the basic tire compound. We need the racing compound. I cannot afford the racing compound just yet. Let's get in this guy's way. So all we have to do is just slow down. He's giving us a punt. He's punting us ahead. Which is good. It's good because it gives us a better speed boost. In an actual race, that would kind of be a bit illegal, I think. I'm not accustomed to racing rules, but trying to give the opposition a punt is not a good idea. Yeah, somebody's trying to steer and in my vehicle. Nice. A bit more silence for me till I do this. We are right up his backside. We're sliding. Oh no! Surprise, motherfucker! Right out of nowhere. Here's the thing. Where are they getting the acceleration boost from? Because from calculations in my head, and the way their cars are, they're approximately about the same gear on the same gear as I was. And because of the previous AI stuff we've seen. You know, we should be able to destroy them. Granted, it's a better AI that's driving the cars. We also have to take into account that the cars may be operating in manual. I am not. So we do have to... we have to be careful. So the next logical upgrade is tire compound, which if done right, we will have better grip, and in theory, it might make it harder for them to push us out of the way. It'll also keep us closer to the ground. So here we have like professional tire compound. We have one dirt tires, rally tires basically. So the professional one is meant, in 1999 logic, is meant to mimic the way the tires would behave IRL in real life. So that's the thing. We have sports tires, and then we have the various racing tires. So that's the thing. The soft tire compound is kinda not what we want. We don't want that. Because the tires are going to be softer on the road, there's actually less grip. And it'll be extra slippery when the tire compound heats up. Same goes with road. If you're on a hot track, and I do believe that still applies. If you're on a hot track like Tahiti, or Red Rock Speedway, or whatever it is, then you're going to be extra slippery going around the corners. So you have to be careful. Whereas if you have the hard compound, it makes it a little bit tougher. But it's still going to be slippery when you friggin... Oh my goodness. So we just have to keep trying different events, get more cash. I forgot to check the engine on this. Is it MR, FR, what? I mean, I could easily look it up IRL, because the specs are meant to match the IRL cars. We are FF, front wheel, front engine, front drive. So if you're... I'm not the most car savvy person. I know the basic stuff, like MR, mid-engine, rear drive, or like, friggin' FR and all that stuff. I'm not a very in-depth person about this, so... What did I say it was? FF? Yeah, let's try an FF race. A basic one. Let's see how we get on. 300 PS! Yeah, we're not winning that. We're getting nowhere with that. Our only hope is to grind out a little bit. But that's the thing. I'm sorry to do this right now, guys, but I will have to BRB and return very shortly. Hopefully you stick around, it'll only be a minute or so. So I shall return very shortly. Alright, you guys, we're back! Fan bloody tastic. I do have a new drink, but it is so tightly wrapped as to stop people from tampering with it. I do appreciate people sticking around. It's fantastic. Feel free to chat as well. Like, you can ask, if you have something to ask or want to talk about something, then feel free to. I'm very much open to it. Okay, so the drink that I have. Hi, Mike. I had to make away from it there. So the drink I have is something called Spike. It's a BCAA drink. Caffeinated energy drink with BCAAs. Because something. I don't know. Hopefully it helps us on the stream, because, you know, the voice can get a bit tiring after a while. I've noticed that a lot. Oh sweet Christ, that tastes like ass. Not that I would know, at least. Oh, sweet Christ. That's enough to turn your bloody mouth into a bubble. It's one of those sour drinks that's sour enough to pucker your lips. Which is like, eh, terrible. So, we have to grind some credits, basically, now. The lightweight K-cup with his AI continually screwed us over. Which is not a problem. It's not a problem because we can overcome it. Sort of. We kind of have to find a vehicle that can fit the thing. A 250 PS race. I don't have a car that's close enough to 250 PS. That's the downside. That's the major downside. Because we have the Still 80, which would be able to do this race. It's able to do this one here. But if I take off the tuning upgrade, it's definitely going to put the PS under 200. Now remember what I said, PS isn't horsepower isn't everything. Because you've seen me win with an under... I'm messing things up tonight. It's terrible. Like I said before, PS horsepower isn't everything. You've seen me win a race with an underpowered car. Granted, it was against a terrible AI. An AI that was able to keep up, even though... When you nip into a race like this, a 250 PS race, you assume the cars that are being used are also at 250 PS. In that case, they would be able to clap your cheeks without much of an issue. So that's definitely a thing. Wagon cup. 400 PS! Oh, sweet Christ. The game is assuming that we have something to take that on. What about 80s? 200 PS! Lovely. Right now, I don't know any place to take parts off of a car. If you have something that's kind of overpowered, they will not let you race with it unless you remove the part or parts from it. There is a way, but it's convoluted and should not exist. If the race detects that you indeed have a car that's a bit overpowered, then... Oh boy. Yeah, if the AI for the race detects that your car's overpowered, you should have the option to downgrade your car if you have the parts to compensate. Like, if you straight up have a car that's like 500 PS, the race is 200, and that has bits and bobs equipped to it, you should be able to downgrade. Like, it should be that easy, but it's not. Either way, we could take on the race, but we're not powerful enough. We are not powerful enough for that race. I believe we're like 291 PS for the silver. Oh, the silver could take on. The hell am I thinking? Yeah, the silver keys. A bit slippy, but, and its acceleration is not the best. Oh, hell, we're doing that. No, wait, the first race cannot be taken on with the silver. That's down. That's a terrible thing. Eh. God. Absolutely garbage! But either way, we're going to try. Might try the FR challenge. Because we're eligible for that. But if the PS difference is too much, then... Oh boy, you're in for a ride, basically. If you take a 300 PS vehicle into a 450 PS race, chances are, you're going to get your cheeks clapped. It would be hilarious. But that's a 250 PS race. We can actually do this one. We are only a little bit behind by, what, 9 PS. That is not much of a difference. That drink is terrible. But the throat needs lubrication. Because we're close to 2 hours of streaming. Which, over time for views, is semi-decent. So let's get the cursor out of the way and friggin' try not to get distracted. Or rather, I need to get in a position first. Oh, fantastic. I'm properly seated. I'm in no pain. There's nothing wrong. Yeah, we this race is in good hands. We could do this. So, for us to do this, we have to be careful. We have to be careful and not crash into the wall, of course. Such is life. Things that can actually put you off are like getting random itches out of nowhere. Is that Lancia? Don't you even try to pick me out. People who do that in races and like circuit racing and all that, they're evil people. They just want to win no matter what, instead of putting skill against skill. Yeah, we shouldn't have put our brakes in. We didn't need to. Excuse you? Get your backside back here so I can run my faster. The sad thing is, they're probably underpowered for the race. Oh, come on. That really... Evil! I will not revert to kiddie tactics. I used to be terrible at this when I was a kid. And the main thing I would do after I shifted this microphone up a bit, because reasons, One of the main things I did was barely even use the brakes. I would scoot forward and turn and hopefully crash into the wall to slow me down. Because reasons. I didn't know how to configure the cars, anything like that. Let's see, can we do it? Can we win this? This is how I kind of used the race. Sort of. But with more wall crashing. And more complaining. Basically. So we slow down right about now. And then turn in. Naturally, they do catch up. But if you get around the corner better than they can, then you can clearly have a bit of a lead. So long as you don't sacrifice too much speed to get around the corner. If you do that, you can run the risk of losing said race. Yeah, we're doing just fine here. Let's go, we're at about 110 miles an hour, approximately. This is the last leg of the race. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on! We can do it! We can win! I think we've just won. Yeah, they're slacking behind. Yeah, we won. See, the thing is, they had a chance to do it. Oh wow, a Lotus Elan S2 and S4. So, oh, it's a Lancer. Half of this cast was Lotus. They had a chance to do it, but for some reason their acceleration wasn't as fast. They were able to keep up. They were able to overtake. That was about it. Their acceleration is terrible. Oh, we got a new car as well. Ah, we get a new car! Let's find out! Let's find out. And I've just noticed we've got a chat. Nice. It's from Egypt, girl. How are you doing? She wasn't asking that. I was just like, asking. So we took on the event. Let's see what we got from it. We got this. 2 million. Are you kidding me? Guys. Are you freaking kidding me? Look at that price that we can sell it for. Oh my goodness. Okay, 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 okay. Once you fully upgrade your silver, do this race. Just do it. It's better than what you could have expected. It's better than what I could have expected, and it's an MR, so I am probably going to keep that. So, the PS for this is 127. 127 PS. So let's check the MR, the mid-engine rear drive section. Let's see what the minimum is. Now MR is midship, so we'll keep that in mind. 350 PS. I don't know if we will be able to do that. It's an international scene. And these cars are not known to be quick. Well, here at least. Let's go back and do that classic race a couple more times. Because we got, what did we get from that? 700,000. We got 700,000. Which is good. 700,000 plus a car valued at 2 million. on resale, nonetheless. Resale! Which means it probably cost about 6 million, maybe even 8 million to buy! Cost wise, I mean. Have to be careful, that drink's full of caffeine. If I drink too much at once, my heart's gonna be weak. And the last thing that I need is to feel like the Flash during the friggin' livestream. Yep, the fastest man around. In any verse. What the hell? Oh no, is that a GT40? What's that? It's a Lancia. Right, we should still have this. If we play our cards right. If we play our cards right, we could win this the next twice. That would net us about 7 million, 8 million. If we sold all three of those Europas, they're way ahead. Friggin' heck. Ah, heck! Now let's see, let's keep on going. Actually, something I want to check. The temperature of the PlayStation is fine. I know this Japanese model that I have can get a bit toasty at times. But that's only at times. And we are getting our cheek clapped big time here. They're way ahead. I want to finish the race. If I finish in third, I want to see who I'm facing. Ah, bollocks! Yeah, exit. That's a hard exit right there, because if we were to continue, there is no way in hell that we would have caught up, like for real. So the best thing to do for us is to try again, which I'm like, sure, why not? Why not? We got lucky the first time, I believe. Unless we can repeat the feat, hey, repeat the feat twice more without fail. So we'll have to be careful, just have to make sure things go well for us, and this and that. Meh. Right, fifth, fourth, we're going into third. Hopefully I'll get to see who's in first, because the friggin' Lancia Delta was, oh wait, where is it? Now we'll never know who the OP punk was, because the Lancia Delta in the last race was in second, and some guy was in, some other car was in first, and because I rage quit, I kind of missed that opportunity. Meh. Terrible. 3, 2, 1. Break. Yeah, we had to swerve to lower our speed because I felt the car slip, and that's a bad sign. That means you're definitely going to spin out unless you can catch it. But because the way this car works, I would not have been able to catch that. We just have to be careful, that's all. Lancia! I'm coming for you, buddy! I'm coming for you, back saint. It seems we're a little Lancia friend. It's driving way ahead! Not anymore! I don't get why the car veers when it hits the bloody wall. And this, that clash against the wall just like bounces it. It's like, what? It's absolute. I wouldn't say it's terrible because it's $19.99. So, meh. And the funny thing is, Gran Turismo 3 does the same thing. Although Gran Turismo 3, all the cars feel like they're on ice rinks. Yeah, we need better tires on this. Yeah, after this race, we're gonna go sell that Lotus. And be like, yo, we're rolling. Rolling, rolling, rolling. We don't have the grip that we should have, because the tires are cooled down. And that's when you know you've got more grip, is when the tires cool down and you like you. But tires heat up from friction. Fuck. Bastards. Yeah, we're not getting that back. I veered. I get out my way. We might be able to make. Might. Let's keep it that way. We're doing it! Oh, man. Oh my god. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. A KPC G10 Skyline. That's a dumb name. That's a very, very dumb name. Oh my goodness. We got first, that's another 700,000. We will be able to upgrade for tire combat. Unless I've already done that. Meh. La 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 la. We have the car that we want to sell along. So we can make that badass cash. That drink is horrible. But I need the drink for now, because what I hate is when I come onto stream and it's all low energy. I want to be full of energy. Makes things more interesting. In certain cases, I'm way more focused. I even took a bit of a nap before stream to try and boost my energy a wee bit. Because the last time I was on stream, I was way too tired, and I cannot deal with that. I don't want to be tired on stream. It's not good for the audience if I am constantly going yawn. It's just not good. In fact, it's terrible. As you've already guessed. So, Nissan, we're at 5 million. I was kind of wrong, but. But when I stated 8 million, that was if we got 3. So, we have more than enough to. I think we do weight reduction. Yeah, it goes like, yeah, we have to get all this. Makes the car lighter, but then we also get to do the fuel upgrade to a racing car. So use 2 million of that for weight reduction, which removes things like interior panels. So we can go for this. But... are we getting blue? Nice. It's 8 million. Now, for the amount of performance you're going to get from it. For 8 million credits, definitely not worth it. Now it's time to see if we have tires. Other tires, I say. I think racing hard should do. There we go. We now have racing tires. That's going to increase our grip a fair amount. Now it's the same with all tires. Once the road and the tires heat up, you're going to slip. So that's a thing. Can we do any more of turbo though? I feel like we can. Stage 3. 4 million! Yeah, we can do more. We can go up to stage 3. Then we can compete in 400 PS. Wow. Oh. It's like, oh, are you beast about it? Then it's like, okay, second one. Oh, I already have it. I already have it, Captain. Alright, can we do anything else here? Can we naturally aspirate the car? Nah. Nun pua. We can do this though. Yeah, we're doing this. We're well doing this. So what I'm going to do is, if in case something goes wrong, I am going to save. Then we'll get the old-fashioned do not remove the memory card. It's fantastic, it's lovely. It's going to take you back to the past. Don't load game. Oh, we'd be in so much trouble. Overwrite. I've got a feeling that would piss a bunch of people off. Alright, let's see. Yeah, that's not safe. Fantastic. So in theory, the car is not only faster, the engine should work better, and we should have better grip on the road, which means we should slip out less. Keep in mind, that's just theory. Yep. Oh, apologies. If it's worse, then oh my goodness. Terrible. But we're going to challenge the historic car. And we are very much going to try and go for the 350 PS level 3 turbo upgrade. So I am very excited for that. Stat race! He said, trying not to burp when putting on a voice. Stat the race! 3, 2, 1! Let it rip! Nice. There's a reference. So... Oh my... Oh no, no, no! Guys. Oh, right. There's something I did forget to tell you. A big thing. And I'd actually forgotten it myself until I'd just seen the car that was parked next to me. Next to me, on the left-hand side, is a Ford GT40. So, you might be wondering, but isn't that normal? Isn't that meant to appear in here, Raj? No, it's not! This car is actually not meant to be in this race. That's like a 600 horsepower car. Now watch, look at this. Watch this car. It's going to blitz everything. Or at least in theory. Yeah, we're doing better. Oh wow, this is miles better. Yeah, that GT40 is coming up. Yeah, check that. Yep. It's exactly like I thought. He's gonna shank it. I have beaten him before. have beaten it before. But like I said, this car is not meant to be in this race. He's not in the car pool. Oh wow, those tires really made a freaking difference. If I tried that on the last set of tires, I would have spun out. Ah! These bastards! Right. That's it! You're on the list! I don't care if you're a bug! You're gone, Dunpal. I'm going to clap your cheeks in a sec. As soon as I catch up. Yeah, in some cases it's better just to slap it in the wall. We're actually not that far behind him. So with the 350 PS upgrade, it should put us up there. Or not! Look at- holy crap! He's like way ahead. Me! Oh! For feck's sake. Like I said, that car is not meant to be in the race. Concentration intensifies. Ah! Rage quit. Rage quit. Friggin' rage quit. Terrible. Right, just to prove a point. Just to prove my point. Let's have a look at the GT40. Should be in the lineup, I think. Not in the lineup, it's in the special. Hopefully. Yeah, this is it. Here's the thing. It's a 310 PS car. But that's not the one that was in there. GT90? That has to be parody. Right, so there's two... For those that don't know, there's two versions of the GT40. I'm about to check the colour palette to make sure you can get in that colour. It was kind of like this colour, but no like overall markings on it. I think. It's a 310 PS car. Do you know why? Do you know why I'm saying it's wrong? I can give you a bit. I can give you a massive hint! The race was 300 PS. Cars that are over 300 PS are not in the pool to be put in the race. There's only ever a selection of 6 to 8, maybe even 9 cars to go in a race. Or that are picked out of a pool to be in a race. Within a specific range. This car should not have been in the race. For some reason, it bugs out and it puts it in the race. Sure, 10 PS might not be much of a difference. That's not the case here. The case I am making is that it wasn't this GT40. case that I'm making is that it could have been a recolored GT40 race car, not the street version. And I don't know why I'm back here. We can't even pick the GT40 up for here. You can get the race version, but you have to win it. And it's on a Red Rock Valley race that you can get it. Which in-game credits for the English version of the game sells for 250,000. So we have to challenge the historic car cup again. So check it. 300 PS. If the GT40 shows up, we need a better look at it. My throat's going dry, so I might have to end the stream at some point. The GT40 is there again! And it actually is the 310 PS. But it is a beast. And because of the driver that's driving it, it's more or less going to be a manual, which means it's going to be faster than I'm going to give it. So that's the thing. We're in first though, but he's going to catch up. Very fast. He already is, he's right behind us. If we can stay in front of him the whole time, then he'll not be able to pass. And then we'll win. I'll just screw it up. So guys, press F. Get your ass out of there, pal! I mean, tickle your stripes. Ah! I'll have to settle for second, unless he screws up. Or I get lucky. Haven't used. Oh, tactics! I'm sliding out! Sliding out! Oh my god. Get your ass back here, boy! You can't compete. Piss off. Now you made me slower than the GT40, and now you don't have a chance. If that Lotus Elan thinks it's got a chance against that GT40, the street version of the infamous race car, then oh boy! It's fine. I've got it. Come on. Skyline. Okay, that's interesting. Come on. Oh! Rage quit. I don't know what made me slip out. Could be a car, could be me. Remember what I said about the tires? When the road and the tires get hot, you can slip out. Good God. If your car is not prepared enough, then you have no choice but to quit the race and restart. Until you get a pool that doesn't contain the GT40. And then you just basically win. I do believe it is. Oh my. Another one! Get out of here. I can't win against it. Even if it's only, what are we at, 291, 298, he's 12 PS higher, yet the difference is the equivalent of 100 PS. It is that much. It feels like that much. But if you think of how each car is tuned, then you get what I'm. Then you can clearly see what I'm getting at. But that's twice. That's three times in a row that's given us a pull with the GT40, and it's in it again. I think. Is it? Oh, thank God! It's a Lancia. Oh. If you don't have the Lancia, you probably have the GT40. If you have the GT40 in this pool, then GTFO, restart the race. It's not worth trying to beat. I don't know if it's in the English version. If you've come across, then feel free to comment down below. Not that anyone is going to watch this far in, so meh. If somebody's watching this at the 2.5 hour mark, nearly 3 hours, or not nearly 3 hours, 2.5 hour mark, then I applaud you, sir, madam, or them, they, whatever you define it as. Can't believe we came across a bug. It's the second time that I've encountered it. I did my own playthrough when I first picked this up. And, oh boy. I was pissed. I had to look into it. But I got lucky once and beat the GT40. Once. Now keep in mind, even if car A has 250 PS and the other one has 280 PS, the 250 one still has a chance to be significantly faster than the 280 one. So PS isn't always everything. A lot of stats are based on your top speed and acceleration, brake power and all that. So that's different. You know what, I'm actually going to retitle the stream. Oh god, I feel a sneeze. I feel a sneeze. Oh god, oh god, oh god, sneeze. Great, now the sneezes went away. Are we going to pull a Mr. Bean here? Where it's like, oh, I'm going to sneeze, I'm going to sneeze, I'm going to sneeze. Oh, nay sneeze. And out of nowhere, a massive sneeze. Also sneeze. Oh my god, I'm not driving the way I should. Because my blood pressure and all that's up, I'm more competitive now, which means I'm reverting back to what I used to race like when I was younger in this game. Oh, our acceleration is terrible. Brake here. Oh god, oh god. Yes, good thing I let off the accelerator. Because when I was sliding, the tires were heating up and making the situation way worse. Which means I lose grip and makes it easier to drift. And that's not something I want. I don't want drifting. Down. Because the slower you're driving, the more grip you will have. But the thing is, you need, what you would want traditionally is tires that don't get slippery at a certain temperature. So that's that. That's literally that done. We've got more cash. Oh my god, my ears! Guys. La 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 la. La 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 la. My voice seems a lot better. Well, not a lot. It's a decent change. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sell the car. Then we'll save and then we'll call it night. Because I don't want to be on here all night. I know for a fact the stream is... Nice colour. I know for a fact the stream might just be boring for a lot of the people that watch my channel. All five of you.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
So, that's a thing. I am actually grateful for everyone that's popped in tonight. Yeah. So we're going to save the game and we'll end the stream there. 2.5 hours is a good time. So right now, I'd like to thank everyone that's popped in so far. It's good when you're watching, but what I'd like to see more from the audience is more chat. It's good if you just want to watch, you don't have to interact, but I want to interact with the audience, I want to get to know the audience more. I want to get to know the audience more. Maybe even find Maybe even find more like-minded people.
Who knows? Who knows?
So, from me to you guys. We've saved! Hopefully. Did we? Did we save properly? Pardon me. Yes, we did. So... how'd that reset? Yeah, we'll sit on the screen. So from me to you guys, thanks for joining in. It's been good having you. But one of the things I'd like to encourage more is more chat. Who knows? Maybe someday you can find a friend in the chat. Maybe some people might be able to connect. Maybe some people might be able to connect with one another in the chat. Maybe we might be friends, whatever. It's a good thing. But from me to you guys, thanks for joining in. It's good. It's great having viewers. It's great when chat happens. I very much enjoy it. I do sincerely mean that, by the way. I hope you all have a great weekend. I will be back on Monday, unless I get bored over the weekend and decide to stream again. To which you might want to follow me on Twitch. Hey, that's a rhyme. I do my board streams mostly on Twitch, so if you want to be notified when that happens, follow me over there. Also, whilst I'm at it, if you've not subscribed already, make sure you have. Click the notification bell to be notified whenever I stream, upload, or post in the community tab. There's a lot coming on the channel. There's more GTA stuff, there's more mods. I'm even going to do a live stream of me modding Sonic Adventure 1 or 2 on console. You heard me right. On console. Keep that in mind. So I'll talk you through all that when I get that prepared. I don't know when I'll be doing it. I just want to tell you that it'll happen. So from me to you guys, I hope you have a fantastic weekend. This has been GTArajgaming. I hope you have a great weekend. I'll be back on Monday. Make sure you're subscribed. Click the notification bell. If you want to support the channel in different ways, share the content. Think about becoming a channel member. There's amazing benefits to it. There's amazing benefits to it that's going to help out the channel. And you will also get rewarded. And other such things. But I digress. From me to you, have a great weekend. I'll be back on Monday. Stay safe, stay hydrated, stay cool. I'll see you then.